Hey everybody, Jess Alstrom here, and I want to make a little video for those of you who are struggling with your weight loss or your gains in the gym. Like, you're not getting the weight loss even though you're working out and eating well, and you're not getting the gains even though you're working out and you're eating well. You're just not seeing what you want, and you're starting to scratch your head and like blame it on age or your genetics. I want you to rethink something we're going to be diving really deeply into in my workshop, Quantum Fitness, in July. We're going to be working in what is actually keeping the progress and the desired goals out of reach for you, because it really isn't your age. The body rebuilds itself every 11 months. The brain rebuilds itself every 7 years, right? Your genetics are designed to be altered, turned off and on. So we know it's not that. So what is it? Well, what is it is, big surprise, it has everything to do with your immunity, right? Your ability to build and break down. And the way that we determine whether the health of the immune system or not is to look actually at the nervous system. And your nervous system is split into two parts, right? Your nervous system is kind of divided by that kind of spinal fluid and that spine-brain connection, because like technically the spine is the brain's tail. So the signals between the brain, the heart, the guts are all communicating. And when you're in a constant state of stress, right, you have these two sides of your nervous system. One side is your fight, flight, and freeze. Okay. The other side is your reboot, your repair, your regenerate, right? So all day long, we're kind of moving back and forth between fight, flight, or freeze and moving back into rest and reboot, right? Normally. But most humans actually stay fight, flight, or freeze even when there's no reason. Let me give you an example. A normal, healthy body that is vibrant and living its best life will move from fight, flight, or freeze very quickly back over into rest, reboot, repair, right? But when we look at the idea of a human, right, versus an animal, and we look at animals constantly in fight or flight, yet they don't drag it out and get mental illness. They don't get ulcers from stress. And we're like, wait, what the heck? So let me give you two analogies here to kind of just play with and understand where your stress is at. One is, there's this fantastic book called Why Zebras Don't Get Ulcers. And it's all about the lifestyle of a zebra and how it technically should have mental illness, because, hey guys, it's black and white. Right? It's a target. It's constantly a prey for something. And it's constantly survival, right? It's constantly in a state of survival. But when it's not in survival, it's not stressed out, right? 15 minutes after a lion chase, that zebra is back at the creek drinking water. It's not even watching its back, right? It's allowing its body to tell it what it needs. When there's danger, the body will react. It's not staying in a heightened state of futuristic danger like humans do. So let's take the human analogy of that situation, and let's think about the last time that you were pulled over by a police officer, right? So you have a police officer that shines the lights on the back. You're like, you know, jamming out to your favorite song, and all of a sudden there's lights behind you, and you become immediately this stress responding person. All of a sudden you're some criminal with a kilo of cocaine strapped underneath your car, because that's how you feel. You definitely go into intense adrenaline, and instead of being able to utilize that adrenaline, it goes all the way into the mind. Now, adrenaline is one of the things I'll be teaching majorly on in this workshop, because most of you don't know how much potential that you have in adrenaline. Adrenaline will amplify your ability to move, heal, think, feel, right? It dumps 600 times magnetism into the blood. And any emotion or any physical stimulation will amplify your vitality, your strength, right? Your fitness. That's why when you're just killing it in the gym, you've got the music, you just feel strong, right? And then when you feel scared, you feel weak and contracted. So your adrenaline is actually amplifying the mind when you're having to sit still in stress. So you're sitting behind a wheel, there's nothing you can do. You can't fight, you can't flight, hopefully. Right? So you sit in this adrenaline, and it's very acidic, and it just kind of starts to eat away, and it has to go somewhere, because it's basically like your superhuman hormone. So it goes into the mind and you start overthinking. That's why immediately you feel like you're in trouble. You feel like, you know, you did something wrong, and you get the ticket. Hopefully it's not too bad, but if it is, maybe it's like tags or something like that. Now you've got the added stress of, how am I going to pay this? What am I going to do? Now I feel humiliated. And you amplify adrenaline and humiliation, that will destroy the gut, okay? You amplify adrenaline with anger, that starts to attack your liver, your gallbladder, your kidneys, right? Because it's got to go somewhere. It's acidic. And mixed with other emotion, it amplifies, it supercharges. Now humans, we sit and we soothe and we just like process. We mentalize everything. So one person getting pulled over equals 2 weeks of a stress response, because not only did I get pulled over, I went ahead and got angry on the way home. I had imaginary conversations in my head. I shamed and guilt myself. I called two people. I told them what happened. I got home. I told two more people. I now have to figure out how I'm going to pay this ticket. Now I'm stressed out about money. Now I'm stressed out about this. 2 weeks later, my body has been in a rotation of a stress response and hasn't actually been able to move back into rest, reboot, repair. So now my sleep cycle is all messed up because my cortisols are too active at night and they're not enough in the morning. So I have crazy mind things that are reminding me of things I did embarrassing in the fourth grade at night. And in the morning, I can't get up, I'm lethargic. And therefore my immunity is constantly in a danger sequence, survival situation, and starvation. Because your body doesn't know the difference between what stress you're feeling. So it can feel like it's starving, it can feel like it's dying, it can feel like it's suffering. That's why when you get attacked by your boss and you're just like sitting there and you're like, ugh, right? You're all that adrenaline. Your body doesn't know if you're dying or not. So it's taking and absorbing that. So it's hoarding food, right? It's shrinking your metabolic stages. It's amplifying your adrenaline function. So your adrenal glands blow out. Your thyroid has to take over for you, right? Your metabolism slows down, because why would you need a metabolism if your life is in danger constantly? Your brain does not know the difference between fear outside of you and fear inside of you. So if you're imagining it, it's happening inside the body. And then you're trying to lose weight, and you're trying to get to the gym, and the body's going, hey, what is she doing to me? She's taking my food. And she's making us lift all these heavy weights. Am I in danger? Because we're always in danger, because we're always in trouble, or we're always broke, or we're always not feeling well, right? So your mental capability to vibrate stress longer and longer periods of time disrupt your body's ability to heal, grow, or in your case, if you're wanting to lose weight, let go, because that fat cell has to let go of the toxins, and it has to be able to shrink back in due time. But first it's going to fill up with water, because it's got to hold something to protect you from all of the stress outside of you. And on the other side, if you're not getting the gains that you want, because we know with epigenetic, we can turn on the superhero genetics, that it is because your body is staying in such a survival space that it's eating its own protein for energy instead of the toxic fat, because it's trying to out-survive the conditions that you're putting it in. Okay, I know that was a mouthful, but this is a tiny piece of what we're going to be working in quantum fitness. It's all about getting metaphysically fit and getting the mind in the driver's seat of the body instead of it controlling it and being that drunk driver that is just lost in stress response. So your nervous system has everything to do with your progress. Your immunity has everything to do with your progress. Hopefully this made sense. Hopefully there's a little seed planted. And if you want information, more information, you can go to my website, jessicaalstrom.com, and you can join us on the adventure on July 20th.